With the release of Godzilla vs. Kong, there are now four films in this MonsterVerse. So what's my ranking of the franchise? Let's find out. Welcome to another new video, everyone. I'm Movie Micah, and today I will be ranking all four MonsterVerse films. As I do with every new release in a franchise, I'm going to rank that franchise, including this new film, Godzilla vs. Kong. What is your ranking of this MonsterVerse? Tell me down below in the comment section. I want to know your ranking, and yeah, without further ado, let's get into my list. Godzilla King of the Monsters is definitely made for the long-time Godzilla and monster fans. Personally, I haven't seen much Godzilla outside of this MonsterVerse, so I didn't care for this much. The action is awesome, as it should be, and this is quite entertaining to watch, but there are parts of this film that completely fall apart. It attempts to have interesting themes, emotional parts, and character moments, but it fails miserably at all of those things. I don't expect a movie like this to even try that, but it did oddly enough, and it all just came off as cringy and stupid. The monster action and visuals are pretty cool, but it's still a bad movie to me because the writing is so awful. It's funny that the critics were saying they wanted more character development from this film. I'd argue they should have focused on the humans less, because they were all so stupid and badly written. Godzilla 2014 is a good way to bring us into this MonsterVerse. It had a ton of potential, and it set up a lot that would come later. However, it does make some really odd mistakes for a big monster movie, and it's probably the most boring of the four movies. But still, I don't think it's bad. For some reason, it kept getting us hyped for some Godzilla action, and it wanted us to be excited, but then every time Godzilla is about to fight, it finds a way to cut away, and that is just really frustrating. The final fight of the movie is great though, and it leaves you somewhat satisfied, I think. This film has great cast as always, and some decent performances, but I do wish they found some way to balance the humans and monsters better. It was really dumb of them to get us interested in the humans, but then kill off the most interesting one. Still, it's a film that I think I would recommend. Godzilla vs. Kong is an absolute blast. It's really satisfying to see Kong and Godzilla battle it out, and from my perspective, this film has everything we could have wanted from it. It's got some fantastic action, of course, and amazing visuals. The dialogue and acting is not good, but I still love it because it's dumb. Godzilla vs. Kong is a pretty dumb movie at times, and I'm okay with that. It has moments that involve no logic at all, and it still has some obnoxious, stupid human characters, but for this, it doesn't bother me. This is a great culmination of the MonsterVerse films we've gotten so far, and it is really satisfying. The issue with the two Godzilla films in the MonsterVerse is that they have stupid plots and stupid characters, but they take themselves seriously. Godzilla vs. Kong is a lot better because it accepts the dumb stuff, and it is just a lot of fun. Kong Skull Island is surprisingly great. Visually, it is the best of the franchise, with the orange and jungle colors, and also the look of Kong himself. He actually looks very real. And then the action is also pretty great. It's just a very well shot movie, and all the action is really thrilling and exciting, and keeps you on the edge of your seat. None of this movie is boring. It is extremely entertaining from beginning to end, and that's basically why I like it so much. It's a very fun time. It also has a phenomenal cast, including Tom Hiddleston, Samuel L. Jackson, John Goodman, and John C. Reilly, and they all play some decently interesting characters, surprisingly. Especially compared to a lot of the other human characters from this franchise, these ones are very good. Also, compared to the other films on here, Skull Island is actually clever, and there's some little things to think about when the film is done. Go into this movie looking for some great Kong action, and you won't be disappointed by that. But who knows, you might actually find that it's more than that. And that's why this is still my favorite in this MonsterVerse. So thanks for watching, that was my ranking of the MonsterVerse. Not the greatest franchise, but it's got the action, and that's what it goes for. That's all I got for this video, I'll see you next time.